Now, I'm reading, to get to a place that we're reading together, Luke chapter 2, verse 41, and I read. Every year, his parents went to Jerusalem for their big feast of the Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went to the feast according to the custom. After the feast was over, while his parents were returning home, the boy Jesus stayed behind him in Jerusalem, but they were unaware of it. Thinking he was in their company, they traveled on for a day. So they lost Jesus for a day. Then they began looking for him among their relatives and friends. When they did not find him, they went back to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple courts, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. Everyone who heard him was amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. His mother said to him, "Son, why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been anxiously searching for you." "Why were you searching for me?" Jesus asked. "Didn't you know that I had to be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he was saying to them. Continue. Then he went down to Nazareth with them and was obedient to them. But his mother treasured all these things in her heart. The last verse. And Jesus grew in wisdom, in stature, and in favor with God and with men. Now let's read the last verse one more time. Let's go to the land presenter. Let's go. And Jesus grew in wisdom, stature, and in favor with God and with men. Let's go one more time. Hear me, Jesus was missing, relocated him after 3 days. I want you to please help me to give the title of my sermon to your neighbor. Look into the face of the neighbor.
My neighbor.
You can be better. Say, my neighbor.
My neighbor.
Say, my neighbor.
My neighbor.
Whatever.
Whatever.
Was missing.
Was missing.
Get ready.
Get ready.
To find it again.
To find it again.
Now tell you the other neighbor. Say, my neighbor.
My neighbor.
Lost.
Lost.
Father, may you speak to us in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the living God. I want to preach this wonderful evening to the wonderful people of God using as a subject, lost but found, lost but found, lost but found. Today marks the 21st of August 2016. And exactly about 30 years ago today, 21st of August 1986, one young man was born in a small town that is called Kewani in Jamaica. And the name of the young man is called Usain Bolt. Today happens to be his birthday. And right now, we locate him as the fastest man alive. He is the person that has been able to break a lot of Olympic records. And as a matter of fact, he's won 3 gold medals in different Olympic games in 3 times. So in all of them, he has 9 gold medals. Nobody has been able to do it. But when this young man was born, he had a condition by the name of scoliosis. And what is this disease about? Your spine is curved. And the moment your spine is being curved, there is a high probability that you will not be able to walk again. But the condition that he had, he was able to overcome the condition, and right now he has become the fastest man alive. I want to pause here to let the Nandi Prayer Center to know that anytime the devil tries as much as possible to fight you, it means there is something great ahead of your life. Because the devil knew who you said Bolt was about to become. So the devil tried as much as possible to bring this condition to him so that it will affect him from doing his assignment. When anytime you find
find a challenge in your life, it means something great is about to happen. The area that the enemy will try to fight you is the same area you are going to make it in life. So just a few days ago, he was running his great race of the 100 meter race. And it was so amazing, and all the other athletes, they wanted to have the gold. But just before they got to the finishing line, this man by the name of Usain Bolt, he started rejoicing. But as you can see from the screen over there, he had not finished the race, but he started rejoicing before he finished the race. Lambie Prayer Center, can I pause here to tell you, don't wait for the battle to come to an end before you start praising God. In one house, the battle is going on. You need to bless the name of the Lord. Listen, in one house, you are going through the issue. Don't wait for the issue to come to an end. You need to bless the name of the Lord. Anytime you can bless God whilst you are going through the issue, it will cause the enemy to be confused. Because while the enemy is throwing weapons at you, you just lift up your hands and say, oh God, I thank you for my life. The greatest individual is the person who is always praising God in the midst of affliction. As you can check from the screen, by the time he got over there, the people that were chasing him, he had given them a space. Can I declare to somebody right now, the people that are chasing after you, God is about to bring some space to you. Listen. The people, the issues that are chasing after you, that are running after you, hear me? They will not be able to catch up with you. Oh, I said they will not be able to catch up with you. Whilst they come, whilst the more, God sends you to a place, God moves you to a place, God elevates you to a place, they will not be able to catch up with you. Hear me? From the same picture, not only would they be able to catch up with you, but God will always keep you ahead of your haters. I said the people who are trying to be like you, they will not be able to be like you. But God will let you go ahead of your haters. Is there somebody here who understands and who believes that God is causing them to go ahead of their haters right now? Now sit down. We move straight into our text. And we'll get to the gospel according to St. Luke chapter of 2, reading from the verse of 41. And the Bible tells us that once upon a time, the parents of Jesus every year goes to Jerusalem into the temple. When I read the Bible and I heard it and I saw that the parents were taking Jesus to the temple every year, I was excited. Why? Because they lived in Nazareth, but the temple was in Jerusalem. And the word Jerusalem comes from two words, Jeru and Salem. Come and say Jeru.
Jeru.
Say Jeru.
Jeru.
And Salem.
Salem.
And the word Jeru simply means a house or a place. And Salem comes from the word Shalom. And by now you know Shalom is peace. So we have Jeru Shalom, which is house of peace. So it means every year the parents were moving into the house of peace. I want to pause here to prophesy to somebody. Every year of your life, God is going to bring peace into your family. I said God will bring peace into your house, peace into your mind. Whatever you do, whatever you touch, God will give somebody the peace of mind. Listen to me, the Bible says, and his name shall be called the Prince of Peace. Listen, whatever situation that is trying as much as possible to take peace away from your life is leaving you from today in the name of Jesus. The power of God that brings peace unto people in the name of Jesus. May God bring somebody peace right now. Somebody shout peace. Somebody shout peace. Somebody shout peace. The Bible says every year they were going to Jerusalem, into the temple according to the custom. But the Bible says, but when they got to the age of 12 years, they went to the temple one more time. When you read the Bible and you see the number 12, it means God is getting ready to do something amazing. Because the Bible says there was a woman who had the issue of blood for 12 years. but she met Jesus on her 12th year. The Bible says there was a young girl by the name of Jairus' daughter, and the Bible says this Jairus' daughter was sick. She died at the age of 12 years and she came back to life. When Jesus started to his disciples, they were 12 disciples. There are 12 tribes in the land of Israel, which means any time you see the number 12, is an apostolic number that God wants to begin to do something amazing. Most of you here, you are over the age of 12 years, and right now you are asking Prophet Daniel, if the age of 12 years is an apostolic number for God to bless my life, then what is it going to happen to me? I want to declare to you, this year becomes your 12 year. I said, this year becomes your 12 year. Any issue you have been through in your life that has tormented your life for a long time, this year becomes your 12 year. It is the 12 year when you meet the visitation of the Lord. Shall I receive it? They went to the temple. But when they went to the temple, at the time they finished, the parents of Jesus now started making back their journey. But everybody here, the Bible says, when they went back to Nazareth, they couldn't locate Jesus. I have a big problem, Prophet Brown. Listen, you are married like you and Amido. You are married with your wife. And you went to the temple with your son. So for Christ's sake, if you are going back and your son is not with you, would you not be able to locate it?
Yes. Yes.
Talk to the Navi prayer center. Yes. Because you are moving, you are three people moving together.
Yes.
And you go to the temple, and you are traveling back to where you came from. The first thing you need to understand and ask yourself, where is the child? But the Bible says they only got to find out that they didn't find Jesus after one day. You move together with the ball, but you couldn't locate even if there was your child, and even after 2 minutes you don't find the child, you get up. I'm like, there's a woman in the house. But for 1 hour, for 2 hours, for 10 hours, for 24 hours, it's when they were able to see Jesus was not around them. Let me tell you something. I want to let you know, there are some people in your life, you think they care about you, but they don't. The same people that you think they will care about you, the same people that you think they will have your back, they are the same ones who will ignore you. Because Mary, for Christ's sake, your birth was not a normal birth. The pregnancy was not a normal pregnancy. You met the visitation of the angel of the Lord. So you're supposed to keep the boy very special. But you only got to know after 24 hours. There are some people who are trying to ignore you. But listen, they can try to ignore you. But what is inside of you cannot be ignored. They can try to constrain your life. But what is inside of you will not be able to control. He was truly at the age of 12 years, and the mother thought that nothing good could ever come out of him. But what was inside of him was bigger and better. I come to tell somebody right now, what is inside of you cannot be ignored. They can try to ignore your name. They can try to ignore you, but they can never ignore your potential. I said they cannot ignore the power that you carry. Listen, all the people who have ignored thinking nothing will ever come out of your life, I speak by the power of God. Whatever was left in your life, God is about to remember your life. Lift up your right hand and shout, "Praise Daniel." That's what I was going to do. Sit down. Mama, for Christ's sake, if you can't find your child for 1 minute, you look at it. Mama, say the truth at all. But for 24 hours. And after, and listen, did you know the time Mary and Joseph got to know they wouldn't locate Jesus? When they went to Nazareth. So they had moved from Jerusalem from the temple. And when you read the Bible, to travel from Jerusalem to Nazareth, it will take you about not less than 7 hours. So you travel all these journey. And you couldn't know that the boy was not with you.
And when they couldn't locate, the next thing they got to do is that the Bible says, and they started, hear me, they started asking their family and friends. When they asked their family and their relatives and their friends, all of them said they have not located the boy. Listen, you might think some family and friends are supposed to be there for you today. But when you carry great potential, most of those people will not be there for you. Because there are many people who are intimidated about what you carry. But so long as they are intimidated about what you carry, does not stop what God is getting ready to do in your life. And the Bible says, when they couldn't locate him in Nazareth, the Bible says, and they started going back to Jerusalem. And they go to Jerusalem after 3 days. But the Bible says, when they go to Jerusalem after 3 days, the boy that they think he was missing, he was located in the temple. Now hear me. When they go to the temple, the Bible says Jesus was not alone, but he was seated together with the great teachers of the law and great people. Oh my God. Listen. When they were leaving him, he was alone. But when they found him again, he was in the midst of great people. All your friends and your haters that left you, by the time they see you, they'll not see you how they left you. They'll see you in your greatness. They'll see you in your elevation. They'll see you in your grace. They'll see you when God is about to take you. Lift up your right hand and shall preach the meal. That's what I was born to do. Listen, when they were leaving him, they left him alone. But when they found him again, he was not alone. It means if some people don't leave you, you cannot meet your great. Mary and Joseph, you thought you were leaving the boy behind. But the Bible says, by the time they saw the boy again, he was surrounded with great people. Listen. God is about to cause great people. Sound something like that. And the only way God can cause great people to surround you is for some people to leave you behind. So from today, anytime you see that somebody has left you behind, begin to just tell them, thank you very much. Because the more you leave me behind, the more you see in my place of power, in my place of dominion. Now, hear me. When they saw him with the great people, number two, the Bible says, and he was listening to them, and he was asking them questions. And the Bible says, and all of the people there, they were amazed. Before he got listening, people were not amazed at him. But by the time they located him, his life became a wonder. Listen, the reason why you went through your rejection is because God wants your life to become a wonder. So that when people see you again, they shall be amazed at what God is preparing for your life. No. Is there anybody here who believes people are going to become amazed at them? Listen. Is there somebody here that who knows? People are going to look at you. They shall be amazed at you. When they see you, they cannot comprehend. Because they don't know. Wait. Do you know the reason why they were amazed? Because they were wondering, for all those 3 days, what did he eat? For all those 3 days, where did he sleep? For all those 3 days, who protected him? If they want 3 days, somebody gave him food to eat, he gave him a place to sleep, then it means God used strangers to be of help to Jesus. London Prayer Center, I came to let you know, strangers you have never located before, strangers you have never seen before, people that you don't know their second name, the Lord is going to cause them to be of help to you. They are going to bless you. They are going to try my best. When strangers come your way and they help you, they sometimes don't try to ask you for anything, because it is God that used them to help you. But how can the stranger help you? It's only when the people who know you have left you. Left my Savior Jesus, and the Bible said, and they were surprised. But then this is what I want everybody to know. They left him, but after 3 days, they were able to locate him. I don't know who I'm talking to, but whatever you lost in the last 3 years, whatever you lost in the last 20 years, I said, what you lost in the last 3 months, whatever you lost in the last 20 months, by the grace of God, in the name of Jesus, you are about to locate it again right now. If they were able to locate it after 3 days, then in the next 3 days, in the next 3 days, in the next 3 days, we are in Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. By the time we get to Wednesday, all the interviews that you lost, you are going to have the appointment again. In the next 3 days, I'm speaking to somebody. In the next 3 days, in the next 3 days, in the next 3 days, in the next 7 to 2 hours, God is going to go see you to locate it one more time. Anybody that was tormenting your health, I said in the next 3 days, God is bringing somebody good health. I said in the next 3 days, somebody shout 3 days. Oh, I can't hear somebody shout 3 days. Shut up.